Hello students, in this video today I will talk about subject verb concord. So here concord means agreement, meaning thereby the verb agrees with the number and person of the subject. Okay, what does it mean the verb agrees with the number and person of the subject? It means singular subject takes singular verb and plural subject takes plural verb. Let's see through examples. He is reading a novel. So here he is subject, which is in singular number. And the verb is also used as a singular verb. Now see example 2. They are singing a song. So here the subject is in plural number, so the verb are is also in plural number. Okay, now I will discuss some rules. Rule number 1, when the subject is a noun phrase, the verb must agree with the head words. For example, one of the girls lives in our colony. In this sentence, the real subject, that is head word, is one, not girls. So the verb agrees here with the head word. Rule number 2. When two or more singular subjects joined by and refer to two separate persons or things, we use a plural verb. For example, Mr. John and Mrs. Mary are walking in the garden. Allahabad and Lucknow are well-known cities. So here, in the above sentences, Mr. John and Mrs. Mary are two persons. And in the second sentence, Allahabad and Lucknow are also two separate cities. So as per rules of grammar, plural verbs are has been used here. Rule number 3. When two singular nouns are joined by and refer to same person or thing, the verb must be in singular. For example, the horse and carriage is at the door. Here in this sentence, the horse and carriage are joined by and conjunction and they refer to the same thing. So the singular verb is has been used here. Okay. Let's see some other examples. The poet and singer is on the stage. Here in this sentence, the poet and singer. These two subjects or singular nouns refer to the same person. So the singular verb is has been used here. Rule number 4. When two singular subjects together express one idea, then the verb will be in singular. For example, 2 and 2 makes 4. Bread and butter is my favorite breakfast. So see here, in the above sentences, the singular subject 2 and 2, and in second example, bread and butter, they express one idea. So the singular verb makes and is are used here. Rule number 5. When two or more singular subjects joined by with, together with, and not, besides, no less than, then the verb will be in singular. For example, Rahul and not Gita is at fault. So here in this sentence, Rahul and Geeta, these two subjects are joined by and not. So the singular verb is has been used here. See the next example. The servant together with the master has left. So in this sentence also, the servant and the master, these two subjects are joined by together with. So the verb has, which is in singular, has been used here. Rule number 6. When two subjects are joined by as well as, the verb agrees with the first subject. For example, Rahul as well as his friends is hardworking. So in this sentence, there are two subjects, Rahul, and second subject is his friends. These two subjects are joined by as well as. So the verb is, which is in singular, has been used here. Next example, his friends as well as Rahul are hardworking. So in this sentence, his friend and Rahul, these are two subjects joined by as well as. So the verb agrees with the first subject. So first subject is here his friends. So the verb are has been used here. Rule number 7. Either, neither, each, every, and everyone are followed by a singular verb. See the example. Each of these girls is very beautiful. Second example is, neither of them gets the highest score. Rule number 8. When the sentence begins with their, the verb agrees with the number of the noun that follows it. For example, there are 30 students in our class. Second example, there was a huge rush in the market. Okay. Now let's see next rule. Rule number 9. When the relative pronoun begins a clause, the verb follows its antecedent in number, person, and gender. So here antecedent means preceding in time or order. In Hindi, we say purvavarti ya pichla. See the example. I met a man who was very old. So here man is a third person singular antecedent. Rule number 10. Nouns which indicate the name of country, province, or title of a book take a singular subject. For example, West Indies is a group of islands. Second example, the Arabian Nights is a collection of stories. In the second example, the Arabian Nights is the title of a book. So, the singular verb is has been used here. Rule number 11. When a plural noun expresses some specific quantity or amount considered as a whole, the verb is in singular. Okay, see the example. 20 kilometers is not a long distance. Rule number 12. Some nouns which are plural in form, but they are singular in meaning and take a singular verb. For example, physics is my favorite subject. So here the noun physics is a plural in form but singular in meaning. So the verb is has been used here. Next example, English is an international language. Rule number 13. A collective noun generally takes a singular verb when the subject stands for the collection as a whole. For example, the jury was unanimous in its decision. Here, unanimous means complete agreement. In Hindi, we say ekmat hona. Rule number 14. A collective noun take a plural verb when the subject stands for the individuals of which it is composed. For example, the jury were divided in their opinions. Okay, students, I think it's enough for the day. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel and share it to your loved ones. Thank you so much.